Today's adventure brings us to Burbank, California, the Bearded Ladies Mystic Museum. This is where I'm heading, directly inside. Wear all black, all the time. Welcome everyone, Adam TheDailyWoo here. This store is full of interesting novelties and unusual pieces of goodness that you can purchase throughout the year. But there is a back room that during this Halloween season is being taken over by a 1980s video store of the horror persuasion. Sounds like something just up my alley. Let's get in there. Join me. Shall you? Wicker casket here on the sidewalk out front shows a skeleton that will be the demise of anyone who does not rewind. Also, a few other items for sale, like this table, this chandelier, and a chair. Oh my goodness, look up in the window. Look at that guy right there. It's a ventriloquist doll. And do I see a mask of Michael Myers? Yeah, I think I do. He's also just hanging out back there. Immediately upon stepping in, see a book of spells and a ghost, a stuffed ghost. Whoa, who's this? This is not your typical Zoltar or Zoltan. Something a little more frightening. A little bit of everything in here for your purchasing pleasure, including skulls or even some heavy metal keys. Quite a paperweight. For one reason or another, this particular guy's behind a glass case. Is that a shrunken head? I highly doubt this broom is used for cleaning or sweeping, most likely used by witches. And these little vials of herbs can be used for creating hexes. Well, breaking a hex, I should say, or maybe conjuring up a spell or two. Not too familiar with this one. A hoodoo bone throwing kit. Whatever in here teaches you how to throw bones. A few different assortment of games. And even a lunchbox you could take to work or school. All kind of goodness. Collectibles from the event. If you want to be part of Vampira's Ghoul Gang, $12. Purchase this pin. And you're in. Paid my admission price. They gave me this oversized postcard-esque ticket. I'm going to make my way towards the door and slowly creep into the back room. It begins. And once I'm in here, Bela Lugosi greets me with a copy of his own film, staring at it very awkwardly. We have just gone back. We have flashback in time, or should I say, slashback shark. One area we will be staying clear of, we will not be peeking into, is the adults only section. But we can look longingly at Elvira next to this wolfman with a Coors Light hat on, or this banner of Ed Wood. They do have a section set up for video games, not new school, but old school video games. And next to the console just so happens to be some 1980s paraphernalia, like Wolfman's Got Nards. And this, who is that? Back to the Future and NES game console definitely is a throwback to my childhood. And the Crypt Keeper and Big Boy standing there next to this old school skateboard. If this boombox turned on, I would crank up some tunes while I tried to accomplish passing this video game. Doing my best. I just screwed up. Okay, moving forward now. In fact, there is an assortment of much more. All different types. Whoa, 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 whoa. What have we here? Come on, come on. Look into my eyes. See what's going on. Oh, wrong. Totally wrong franchise. Get that. Why is that knife pointed directly at my backside? Get that. Come, Michael. Put that thing away, please. We need to start moving into the kids section. And I guess I actually like this as a teenager and young adult. Gotta love some gym varnish. Being in here is really amping up the nostalgia factor, to say the least, because I used to work at a place in my younger years very similar to this one. Granted, we had more to rent than just horror films, but our scary movie section was nothing to scoff at. I would stand behind a counter just like this one, waiting for the next customer to walk through the door, to make a recommendation, to tell them about something they had possibly never seen before. And after they were sold on that item, then upsell a candy bar, some popcorn perhaps, and they'd slide their way over to the old school register to be rung up. They got some good stuff down in here. Some trading cards, some of them I've never seen, like The Reanimator, or even one of my favorite zombie movies, Dawn of the Dead. Never realized they were playing cards. Like, who could forget Beta from the Betamax era? There's Piranha 2 and a few other titles you might remember. Ooh, Surge and Crystal Pepsi. We're going full throwback mode. Don't call that number. Trust me, don't call it. Slashback Video. Cleverly named The Revenge of Slashback Video for this year's pop-up. This is the second edition, the second time this has happened at this same location, making this a sequel, if you will. Something a little more frightening, a little more scary, a little more terrifying. They even have Laserdiscs. Terror Train, Dracula, Chucky, and you know, there's a couple duplicates like Dracula, the old school Dracula, Prom Night. We're getting into Jamie Lee Curtis territory. The Thing, Night of the Living Dead, some Romero here, Silent Night, Deadly Night, Starman, and Them. I don't know why Starman was in there. That's, I guess that kind of fits in a sci-fi kind of way, but nonetheless. Some artistic interpretations of some of these, like this little creature in the Blob case. And over here, someone has cut away the actual boxes with Arnold on the left and Linda Blair, Reagan, on the right, peeking her head out of the case. The movie Inside a Movie from Scream 2. We have the box for Stab. And that's very creative. As far as I can tell, none of these are original artwork and original boxes from the films. They are just something that people put together, you know, sparking up their creativity. Feels like I'm in a time machine, just walking through here, just wandering through. Everything from the carpet to some of the toys in the bottom of the case, like the house from House, and even Freddy Krueger over there. And these candies are full of little teeny tiny, yeah, those are skeletons. And if you have to return something, you throw it down in the dead alive mouth return slot. Nice. Watch closely. The man in the glasses now turns into an alien from They Live, John Carpenter's They Live. Look, he's back to human form. You don't want to see him switch back over, so I'm just going to look at this bulletin board and then paint. Oh, wait, whoa. Sorry about that. I didn't mean to do that. Everything in here does not even feel like anything in the last 10, 20, maybe even 30 years. It all has an air of the 80s, including that cardboard little piece up there. Up there is, that's actually Stephen King, who, if you remember the trailer, said he's going to scare the hell out of you. And then Freddy came along and pretty much knocked it out of the park. While in here, there is a movie playing on the old school technology. It's not Blu-ray, it's not 4K HD, but on a little TV. Toxic Crusaders. I'm just gonna give you a little slide by of some of the games like Gremlins 2, Friday the 13th, Castlevania. Dun da dun, dun da da dun. I feel like it needs some theme music in here. Dun da dun, dun 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 dun. Dun. Dun da dun, Horror Hospital, Fight for Your Life, and who can forget Invasion of the Blood Farmers, and next to that, Scream Baby Scream. Dun da dun, da dun 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 dun. Speaking of video games, here's an arcade version, one I've never played before, called Splatterhouse, where you're wandering through the woods, and then you go inside a haunted house, and then suddenly, you're wading in water, you're attacking people that are attacking you, even though you're the attacker or the attackee. It's Splatterhouse. Dun 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 dun. Remember this movie, My Demon Lover, the boyfriend from Family Ties? Dun 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 dun. Down to the new release wall. These also, I do not believe, were original artwork. Something like, what is this over here? Dead? Dead the Foot? And this is an unusual version of Dead Alive, still ripping open the mouth. Getting back into some more artistic endeavors as we scroll. Oh, here's the Book of the Dead, a very gruesome looking Book of the Dead, and an action figure dedicated to the landlady, and even a 3D version pop-out, one on the end I am not familiar with, but that looks like the Shining maze, and one of my personal favorites, Halloween 3. Look at that. The roaches and snakes are popping out of it, and I would have got away with it too if it wasn't for that pesky boogeyman. Here's another Book of the Dead. There's two of them. The next room over, there's two back rooms. There's the front gift shop area. Then there's the video store. And then there's this particular section with couches. You'll even see a framed photo picture of Loomis up there with his gun. Down below the Crazies poster are other assorted posters that you can purchase. Most of the stuff in here is not allowed to be bought in Slashback Video. However, the posters are for sale. So if you make it down here, feel free to pull out your wallet and take one of these beauties home with you, like a Puppet Master one, or maybe even a Ghost Story one. I believe this television is also for sale. This piece of artwork has a price tag on it. And if you're brave enough and in for a scare, it could be yours. Dun 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 dun. Spoiler alert. I don't think he really does die. You have to wonder from Hellraiser if Pinhead, did he ever have a membership card? Did he ever have his address and phone number on file? And if he did, along with these guys, did they ever have late fees? I'm sure occasionally they had to have brought back a VHS cassette a little bit late in the game and had to pay a penalty. That is a hanging piece of corn with a sickle on it. I could spend a whole lot of time in here just reliving my younger years. The simpler time of movie watching. Way before the internet. Way before you could just download something or scroll through it on some sort of website. Half the time you didn't even know what the trailer was going to be about. You just had to guess by looking at the front of the box or even scroll around to the back and just assume that it would be something you would enjoy. Then you'd spend your hard-earned money on it, take it home for the weekend, watch a few minutes of it, turn it off, or maybe it was your new favorite film. You'd end up watching it once, twice, three, four times that weekend and end up buying it later on when it became available for purchase. I think that's part of what this place is about. The Mystic Museum and the pop-up in the back, the Slashback Video. It's about reliving the good old days and a little horror thrown in for good measure. Never hurt anyone. That's going to do it for today from the return of Slashback Video, a pop-up video store slash exhibit here at the Bearded Ladies Mystic Museum. Running until the end of the Halloween season. See you guys in the next video. The vlog is over.